When my father's sister and her husband were Jehovah's Witnesses, Auntie would take us to the meeting. We used to spend night and day studying. I liked what I was learning, and what really got to me was the hope of everlasting life in paradise, because I hated death as a child. A year after I was baptized, I decided to do full-time service, but my employer didn't want it, and so he did everything to discourage me. I was determined, regardless of what, I was going to find there. I went to Ver. It was an isolated territory. It was very hot down there. There was no congregation or anything there. We didn't have public transportation, so we depended on our feet to go from door to door. We crossed rivers, take off our shoes, and go across the water. It was a very productive territory. If I call at, say, 3 or 4 doors, you get 2-3 Bible studies out of it. And if you have 10 Bible studies, you can say from the 10, sometimes 4 persons out of them take their stand. And then in a short while, we're able to form a group, an isolated group, which eventually grew to be a congregation. We were married for 15 years. He loved the ministry. 2001, my husband died in May, and then it was in August I was diagnosed with cancer. You can imagine coming out of one situation into another situation. And it was quite devastating because it got to fourth stage. And I said, Jehovah, I do not want to die. The doctors did very well. Jehovah supported me, of course, 100%. I never thought of stopping full-time service. We know Jehovah is not the one responsible. Jehovah in his love has made arrangements to get us out of it. So whatever it is that we're going through, Jehovah knows he supports us. And when we think how insignificant we are, you know, and how he reached out to us, sent his son, I feel privileged to be used by Jehovah. When difficult situations come, I am not worried. All I keep saying, Jehovah, please, don't let me give up full-time service. And so I keep on encouraging my younger ones, especially, keep your face and thought and everything on pioneering, and don't worry, just go on. So I see myself as planting and watering, and Jehovah is making it grow. And it let me feel very useful to Jehovah. And I have no regrets at all for all the years that I have pioneered, because I recognize that I have not missed out on anything. The only thing I've missed out on, really, are the troubles that I could have gotten in.